you. Thank you so much. Welcome to this afternoon's musical encounter. We're so happy to have you all here. My name is Allison Bowles, and I'm the Education and Community Programming Director for La Jolla Music Society. Before we dive into the encounter, I did want to let you know that today is the first day for single ticket sales for our 54th winter season. I hope that you'll stop by the box office or visit theconrad.org to check out all the amazing concerts and educational events that we have planned for the rest of the year. Today's musical encounter will feature Erin Keefe with the Aestas Trio, joined by Sung Jin Lee from the Pelia Quartet on the second half of the program. Erin is the Concertmaster for the Minnesota Orchestra and an Avery Fisher Career Grant. For now, we'll have the Pelia Quartet out, and they will speak a little bit about the Haydn String Quartet you're about to hear. Please enjoy. Thank you so much.
My name is Nathan, and so happy to have you here this afternoon, even though it is such a beautiful day outside. So we're really grateful to have such a nice audience. We're going to be playing Haydn's Opus 64, number 4. And Haydn, as you probably know, was called the father of string quartets. He wrote dozens and dozens, I think even over 100 of these quartets. And, you know, for us, living in today's day and age, 2022, you know, it's easy listening. Haydn is pretty straightforward and simple for us because we've had a lifetime and a century of, two centuries actually, of more complicated music, right? So we have jazz and we have Schoenberg and we have contemporary music and everything that to our ears now is a little bit more surprising than Haydn is. But when Haydn was writing, he was doing some surprising things as well. And so when you listen this afternoon, I encourage you to put yourself back in the 1890s and to listen as a Haydn audience would have, maybe at the Esterhazy Palace. He wrote this right before he retired and went to London. And try to be surprised by the little changes when it goes from major to minor, when there's a surprise dissonance, all those little things that nowadays aren't so surprising. But for Haydn, they were quite surprising. And we'll do our best to bring them out for you, and we hope you enjoy.
Thank you. Hello.
Oh, whoa. So it works. Hello, everyone. My name is Andrew. Thank you so much for joining us this afternoon. We're very excited to be performing in our first encounter here at La Jolla SummerFest. Our trio, the Aestas Trio, will be joined by Sung Jin Lee of the Pelia Quartet and our senior artist, Erin Keefe. And today we will be performing the piano quintet written by Johannes Brahms in 1864. So just to give you a brief background on the work, it's considered the crown of his chamber music works. And it was published in 1865 and was originally, interestingly, conceived for cello quintet, which means string quartet with another cello. And it was inspired by Schubert's cello quintet in C major. But after an initial reading, the colleagues that read the piece and Johannes Brahms decided that the power of the music wasn't coming through with the arrangement of a string quintet, so they decided to try rearranging it for piano sonata for two pianos. And after Clara Schumann heard it, she said, and I quote, "Its skillful combinations are interesting throughout, but please, dear Johannes, for this once, take my advice and recast it." So with this advice, Brahms recast the piece for piano quintet, and he was finally satisfied, and so was Clara, who found the work a worthy successor to her husband's piano quintet. So this will be the version that we present to you this afternoon. It's been such a pleasure and privilege to work with this group and to work with Erin. It goes without saying that we learned so much rehearsing with her. And thank you again for coming, and we hope you enjoy the concert.
Thank you. Thank you. Thank you.